Is this the first wedding ever in Cheers Cove?
Nope. Frankie Flaherty got married in this barn home.
Yeah?
Yep, he met Janet right down there at that corner. Proposed to her right here, right in front of me. They got married over there, had their first fight up by the piano. She caught him in the pool room with a woman, shot him dead in the alley.
Whoa, that's an incredible story.
Really?
Want to know where he's buried?
Where?
He ain't. He's cremated.
Thank God.
This is ashes. Gee, Eddie, it really is. It's been nice talking to you. Oh, by the way, Eddie, did I tell you that my wife passed away some time ago? Yeah. Oh, well, thanks, Eddie. I really appreciate that. Is your wife dead yet, Ed? That's good, really. Listen, Eddie, I want to thank you for thinking about me, huh? And I'll get back to you. So long, pal.
What is it, Coach?
Pal of mine, Eddie Fuentes. He manages in the winter leagues down in Venezuela. He says if I can learn Spanish, he might have a job for me, coaching.
You mean you're going to return to coaching, Coach?
Yeah, Collie. Baseball's so much simpler than life, you know? In baseball, I always know where I'm at, right? We're up, I'm in the coach's box. They're up, I'm in the dugout. The game is over. I hit the head, get a cheeseburger.
Sounds like a great life, Coach.
It's terrific.
You know any Spanish here, Coach?
Yeah, Cliff. I took some courses for a couple of days just to learn a few phrases, you know?
Oh, yeah? Like what?
Like, how tall is my dentist, and is that really your sister? just enough to get by.
You're gonna do fine, Coach.
Thanks, Cliff.
He didn't tell any of you? Coach?
See?
Did you know Sam has a brother?
Of course I know he had a brother. He hates him.
Why does he hate him?
He was cruel to him. When Sam was a kid, he used to shove his head underwater.
Ooh.
Hey, wait a minute. That was my brother. Come to think of it, that was my head.
Coach, don't Sam and his brother spend any time together?
Oh, they get together whenever he's in town, but he's never been to Cheers.
Well, he's coming now, and someone has to tell Sam.
Let me do it. I'm a smoothie about breaking bad news.
Yeah?
Sam, your apartment burned down. You lost everything.
Oh, my God. Really?
No, no, no. Your brother's in town. He's on his way over. Makes you feel better, doesn't it?
I hate it when you do that, Coach.
Oh, come on, Sam. It cushions the blow.
Don't worry. He's got better taste than that.
Sam! Compadre! Necesita mi ayuda.
What?
Your brother's teaching me Spanish.
You're learning the Spanish language in one evening?
No, no, Sam. No entirimente, no. El tenso subjetivo es muy difícil.
Ernesto, Ernesto, venga, voy a bailar.
Sí, venga, venga, Derek, venga. Sam, you want me to take the bar
no,
over?
No.
Oh, I get it. I get it. You'd rather be here when he's back there, right?
Yeah, something like that.
People don't have to draw pictures for me, Sam. Although I like it, but they don't have to. Venga! Venga, venga, Derek! Ha-ha!
Hey, jefe! Well, Coach, it's just clear we've reached a philosophical impasse here. You know, much like the question of the tree falling in the woods.
The what?
The tree falling in the woods.
Oh.
The question is, if a tree falls in the woods and if there's nobody there to hear it, does it make a sound?
Well, if there's nobody there, I mean, how do you know it fell?
Well, Coach, we assumed that it fell, you know.
Yeah, but you don't know.
All right. Okay, Coach. I went into the woods yesterday and saw the tree laying there on the ground.
Well, a bunch of beavers could have chewed at it and then gently lowered it to the ground, Cliff.
Well, you got me there on that one, Coach. How about another beer, huh?
I'm telling you, you surprised me, Cliff. You're not prepared at all tonight.
Yeah, well, I fell asleep while I was going over my notes preparing for our conversation today, Coach.
Oh, you do that too, huh?
Coach.
Not today, Carlo, please.
What can I get you, honey?
I'll have a soda water. Oh. You know what, Coach? You never take a day off.
No, Thursday's my day off.
You work every Thursday.
Yeah, but I go a little slow, you know? So tell me, how you doing?
Not very well.
Well, what is it?
It's Derek.
Well, what about him?
He's flying to Paris today, and he wants me to go with him. He's a charming man, Coach. He's everything I've been looking for. And I think he's interested in me, too.
Gee, what a lousy break. Well, wait a minute, Diane. Maybe it's good.
Oh, it is good.
I'll tell you why. The second I looked at you and Derek, I said, now there goes a cute couple.
Yeah. What about Sam?
Well, Sam and Derek are a little cuter, yeah.
Coach, let me ask you a question.
Diane, you're asking a guy who's taken a lot of fastballs in the head. You sure you want to ask the question?
Coach, do you think I'm a smart person?
You're the smartest person I ever met.
Well, I, Diane Chambers, bred and educated to walk with kings, once offered a full scholarship at the Sorbonne, have allowed myself to become attracted to a 6'3" bubblegum card.
Well, gee, I think I can help you with the sore buns, Diane, but... yeah, the rest of what you say is all over my head.
Coach, I'm making a confession here. Not just to you, but to myself. Maybe I'll feel better after I say this. I got it.
You're hot for Sam's chili.
I think Keats would have said it differently. But I'll accept that.
Look, Diane, if you like Sam at all, I don't understand what the problem is here.
Derek's making a commitment. All I ever get from Sam is adolescent flirtation. I'm not sticking around for that. If he'd give me something, anything, I'd stay.
Diane, you don't understand Sam. Sam's the kind of a guy, you know, he keeps his feelings to himself. I mean, the more he cares about something, the less he shows it. I've been with him through his divorce, through his boozing, through the end of his career. And let me tell you something, the tougher things got, I mean, the cooler he got. You know something? It's a damn sure bet that if he's not expressing himself to you, he's nuts about you. Or he couldn't care less.